Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science Rockstar Edition. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. You often hear a lot in the news about extractables and leachables, especially when it comes to food products or anything that goes in our bodies. I can't help but look at my water bottle sitting in my car on those hot summer months and wonder if anything from that bottle is now in the water and should I drink it? What really are these extractables and leachables, and why should we care? In this episode of Behind the Science, I know just who I can ask this critical question to. Lack, I'm so glad I found you.
Hey, Jen, how are you?
Great. So you do extractables and leachables testing.
Funny that you mentioned. I'm actually working on one right now.
Perfect, because I have a question. I have this water bottle in my car, and it was really hot out, and it was sitting there for a while. And in the news, I've heard a lot about extractables coming from plastic in my water bottle. Is this not poisonous?
Whoa. It's not as crazy as it sounds, but yes, you do have a valid concern about extractables and leachables. They're also present in chem material, they're also present in cosmetics, and also in pharmaceuticals.
So do you mean it could be in my lipstick and mascara?
Absolutely. In fact, if you like, I have to put up some work together on the whiteboard and we can go take a look at it.
That'd be great. I love a good whiteboard.
Awesome. Let's go. Jen, as you can see here from the whiteboard, extractables and leachable testing is of interest across several market segments. The regulation differs across each one, but the end result, well-characterized packaging or contact material, is a common requirement to avoid harm to the consumer or patient.
All right, so it's important to understand and minimize extractables and leachables, but is this easy to test for?
You make a very good point. In fact, the most important thing about extractables and leachables is these are in such low concentration, you need instruments with high level of sensitivity. And this can be done either using a GCMS or LCMS, in this case where we're using our top instrument, which enables us a higher level of sensitivity and accurately identify peaks of interest using our Unify. So the application, I'm not limiting to just, you know, waters stored in bottles, but also to cosmetics and to pharmaceutical compounds. Let's go to the whiteboard once again.
All right, let's do it.
If you look at the bottom left of your image, the reference, which is the red trace, and your sample, which is the blue trace, and the green is the difference in between the two traces, which is basically indicating all those that are present in your blank has been removed from your sample and only the peaks of interest that might be of cause of concern. And when you double click on the green trace at the retention time of 3.8 minutes, it actually pulls out a mass spectral information, and with the help of Unify Spider database search, you will be able to confidently identify the peak of interest. In addition to that, the match type, which is highlighted in the blue box, is highlighting if the candidate is present only in your unknown sample, which is referred to as unknown unique, or it may be present in your reference sample, which may be tagged as reference unique, or if it is present both in your reference and your sample, then it would be tagged as common unique. The other aspect here is the unknown reference ratio, which basically indicates and quickly allows the user to identify common extractables. A response ratio of over 3,000 would indicate the presence of an unknown impurity.
The safety of pharmaceuticals, cosmetics, and food may be compromised by chemical compounds in the various types of packaging and materials that are in direct contact with the consumer product. Therefore, testing of these extractables and leachables is very important. For more information on all the work described in this episode, go to the following link below. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science Rockstar Edition.